are going to discuss about my screen is visible, my video that is visible to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
So now in today's session, we are going to discuss about coffee vending machine. Is a one of the application. Actually, now what we are going to do, we are going to have a VHDL code for this coffee vending machine. That means now suppose we want to design a particular chip for this application. So how to write a VHDL code for that we are going to decide. Now I think all of you have seen vending machine, yes or no? You must have seen a vending machine for tea, coffee, or you must have seen vending machine for soda. Okay, but I think all of you have seen vending machine. Okay, that means at bus stations, railway stations, or hospital. I think there is one vending machine at our college also. Okay, so a vending machine, that means it is the machine in which you can put certain money, and then depending on whatever is your requirement, that means how you are pressing the buttons that are placed on that machine, so you will get that particular item. Okay, so if it is a machine for coffee, tea, and suppose juice or something, so that you can do. That you can have using that machine. Okay, so that okay. Wait a minute. I have just. Okay, in this problem, we are just taking a simple example. Okay, so that means we are just considering a coffee vending machine. We are not going for another option. Okay, jasa tumhi baghitla tar bharpur sare options ya vending machine madhe available astat ki jacha pramane je ekas machine madhe tumhala chaha, coffee, green tea, then soup asas bharpur kahi options available astil, pan tyamule tumchi state diagram vadat jaite, mothi hot jate. Okay, so here we are just going to consider a very simple example where when you put a money in that machine, you will get a coffee depending on what type of money you are putting in that machine. Okay, so we want to get a coffee. Okay, so this is our first what we can say, this is our first option. Okay, we want a coffee. Okay, now what we can first of all, that machine that may be in an idle state. Okay, so that means it will not be giving any coffee, or it is not returning any money, so it is in an idle state. Okay, or you can say it as a reset condition. Okay? So this is the one condition for this coffee vending machine. Now after that, what you can do, in the next state for this is that you are putting money in that machine. Okay, so this is the another option. Now if you are, that means after idle state, it will go into the state that is a put money. Okay, now whenever you will be in this state, okay, there could be four options. Okay, now I'm just considering different options. One is that let us consider that this coffee that cost 5 rupees. Okay, so So now, as we know that we have the coins, okay, so this again one more assumption that it is accepting coins. Okay, so this machine that is accepting coins, and then these coins, okay, as we have a coins of 1 rupee, 2 rupee, 5 rupee, or 10 rupee. Okay, now as we are saying that this coffee, it cost for 5 rupees. Okay, so that means 1 rupee and 2 rupee, these are the wrong money, because it will not be okay. So now again we will assume that only one coin is inserted in that machine, so these coins that will be wrong coins for to get the coffee. Okay, now 5 rupees and 10 rupees, these are okay. Okay, so we can get a coffee if we insert these coins. But again, whenever we are receiving a 5 rupees coin, that means we can get a coffee here. But as the cost of that coffee is 5 rupees, so there will not be any return money option. Okay, but if I am inserting 10 rupees coin, that means user can get coffee also, but at the same time we need to return 5 rupees to this. Okay, so that means there should be return money if he is inserting 10 rupees coin. Okay, so that means whenever we have the in a state, we are in a state of put money, so we will have 4 options. One is that, okay, this, let us say that state as a 0-0 state, that means we are not inserting any coin. Though we are in the state of put money, but we are not inserting any money, so that is a no coin option. So another option that could be, that we will say as a 0-1, that is we are inserting wrong coin. Okay, so that means it could be a coin of 1 rupee or 2 rupees. So that is the wrong coin, that is the another option. Okay, so when we are in this state, okay, so you will not receive coffee here, so coffee will be not received, but here whatever is the coin inserted, that should be returned to the customer, so coin should be out. Okay, so that means there should be return of that money, because that is not useful. जे काही त्यांनी इन्सर्ट केलं ते त्यांचं त्यांना परत द्यायचंय, म्हणजे 1 रुपये किंवा 2 रुपीचं कॉइन जर त्यांनी इन्सर्ट केलं असेल, सो वी आर गोइंग टू रिटर्न इट. ओके, सो दिस इज द अनदर ऑप्शन. नाउ थर्ड ऑप्शन, दॅट इज सपोज 1-0. ओके, सो 1-0, दॅट मीन्स दे हॅव इन्सर्टेड अ 5 रुपीज कॉइन. ओके, सो 5 रुपीज कॉइन, सो ही मे गेट ऑर ही विल गेट, नॉट मे गेट, he will get coffee. Okay, so coffee will be received, but as the cost of that coffee is 5 rupees only, so coin will not be returned. Okay, so this output will not be at a high logic level, so it coin not returned. Okay, because it is a 5 rupees coin that is inserted. Now fourth option, that will be suppose 1-1 option, and that means you have inserted 10 rupees coin. Okay, so if 10 rupees coin is inserted and as coffee cost for 5 rupees, so that means you will get a coffee, okay, that will be received, but at the same time coin that will be returned. Okay, so lakshat ala tumcha kay honar aahe ki we have a coffee vending machine which serves only coffee. Okay, as we are taking a very simple example, so we are considering that we are going to have a coffee vending machine which serves only coffee, which cost 5 rupees. Okay, now you customer may insert 1 rupee coin, 2 rupee coin, 5 rupee coin, or 10 rupee coin. If he insert 1 rupee or 2 rupees coin, then we are not going to serve him a coffee, but whatever is the coin that is inserted, that we are going to return him. Okay, so that is the first option. If he is not inserting any coin, then we have to make them to put money. Okay, so that means we will be there in this state only. Okay, till he is entering or he is inserting the money. Okay, so if he is inserting 1 rupee or 2 rupee coin, so coffee will not be served, and whatever is the coin inserted, that will be returned to him. Okay, after that, if suppose customer inserts 5 rupees coin, so that means here we will have to serve him a coffee. Okay, but as there will not be any return of the coin, okay, so we are not going to return him any coin because that he has inserted sufficient money only, okay, so which is required to get a coffee, so we are not going to insert any money. Okay, now suppose the third option is that he is inserting 10 rupees coin. Okay, so if he is inserting 10 rupees coin, that means he should be served with a coffee, as well as he must he should be returned a coin. Okay, so we will have that option also. Okay, so for that, let us consider that we have a this coffee vending machine. Okay, so this is a machine. So I'm showing this machine as a block. Okay, so it will have one input, that is a clock. Okay, so depending on the clock, it will be working. And then it will have the another input, that is a coin pin. Okay, and it will be having one more input, that is a reset. Okay, so you can manually reset this machine. So for that, we are having a one input, that is a reset. Then this is a clock, as this is the sequential circuitry that we are going to design. So it will require a clock, so that clock input will be there. And then we have one input, that is a coin in, because on that only this machine will decide what to give. Okay, then we will have two outputs. One is the coffee out, and another output, that is a coin out. Okay, so what we have, we have three inputs. One is the clock, another one, that is a coin in, and third one, that is a reset. And we have two outputs. One is the coffee out, and second one, that is a coin out. Okay, so these two outputs will be there for this machine. Okay, now let us see what will be the state diagram for this. Okay, so let us consider that first of all, this machine is in an idle condition. Okay, so this is the first case state of this machine. Okay, so in idle state, coffee out, that is equal to zero, as well as coin out, that is equal to zero. Also, coin in will be also equal to zero. That input is also equal to zero. And this coffee out and coin out, that will be zero, because no coin, no any out. Okay. Now, from this state, this machine will go into the next state, that is a put money. Okay, so this machine will request customer to put money. Okay, and then in this state, if suppose we have coin in, that is equal to 00, that means there is no any coin inserted, so it will remain in a same state, and in that state, coffee out I was mute for some time. Okay, so I will be repeating once again these things. Okay, am I audible? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so shall I repeat once again?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so first option is that we have no any coin inserted, so coffee out will be equal to zero and coin out that will be equal to zero. Suppose we have inserted a wrong coin, that means the coin in that is equal to 01, but in that case we are returning to the idle case by making coffee out is equal to zero and coin out that is equal to one. That means we are returning that coin. Third option is that we are inserting 5 rupees coin. So user will get or the customer will get coffee, but no any coin because it cost for 5 rupees. And after that, he will return to the idle state. Okay. And the fourth option is that he is inserting 10 rupees coin. So after serving a coffee to the user, so coffee out is equal to one as well as giving a 5 rupees coin return. It will return to the idle state. Okay, so these will be the state, different states in this machine, and this will be the state diagram, that is the FSM for this coffee vending machine. Okay, now let us see.
हेलो मैम,
हेलो
आवाज
मैम,
नहीं आते।
क्या कर रहे हो
एक्सक्यूज मी
आप?
मैम,
Am I audible?
यस मैम।
Okay, actually, whenever I start my video that time from mobile, it gets overheated, and because of that, I have to leave from this meeting. Okay, but now, as I'm going to now share a VHDL code for this, so video will be off now. Okay, so no worry. Just hold on till I once again connect from my laptop. Okay, till then, is this clear to you? This state machine diagram, that is clear to you? Is it clear? If anybody has doubt, let me know. Avinash, hello Avinash. कुणाला काही डाऊट आहे का? याच्यामध्ये कन्सेप्ट कळला? ओके, so I will be sharing my VHDL code now with you. So this is the VHDL code. One sec, just hold on. So I have shared my screen. Okay. So it is a VHDL code for this copy vending machine. Okay. So as I said earlier, we will have three inputs. That is, one is the clock, then reset and coining. Okay. So these are the three inputs, and we are going to have two inputs. That is, a copy out and coin out. Okay. So in NTT, all these codes that will be declared. That is, clock, then reset, coin in. These are the input ports, and coffee out and coin out, these will be the output ports. Now, as coin in will have four states, so instead of having this coin in input as a bitwise, I have taken it as a vector. Okay, so it is having in the range of 1 down to 0. That means it will have four different values: 00, 01, 10, and 11. Okay, so depending on this value inputs, it will be decided whether there is a no coin or whether there is a wrong coin or whether there is a 5 rupees input or 10 rupees input. That will get decided on the combination that is available at the coin in input. Okay, so here this is the entity declaration part for this VHDL code. Now let us move towards the architecture of this entity. Okay, for this entity, so let us have first of all declaration of the states that are present in this code. Okay, so we are declaring here in the architecture, these are the different states. That is, a state type, that is a idle, put money, then wrong money, or input 5 or in 10. Okay, so these are the five different states as we have discussed earlier in while discussing state diagram. So these are the different states that will be present. And then I have declared one signal, two signals rather than one. These are the one is the current state and another one that is the next state. Okay, so these are the state types for the all these state. Okay, or these will be the values for the state type. Okay, so now let us start with the actual architecture of this entity. So here let us begin. Okay, and then we have first of all the first process. Okay, so there will be two processes in this architecture. So out of that, one is suppose that which where we are going to discuss about what will happen after reset signal is active or if it is not active. Okay. So now here I am considering active low reset signal. So here suppose RST, that is a reset signal, is equal to zero, then current state that will be equal to idle. Okay. So that means it will remain in a idle state only. But if reset is equal to one, then if there is a clock event present, that means if there is a change in the clock signal, and if clock is becoming one, then current state will be next state. Okay, so whatever is the next state, that will be the current state now. Okay, so end of this if statement and end of the process. So that means if we want to work that cafe vending machine, so we need to put RST that is equal to, or reset that is equal to one. So that means it should be at a high logic level. Okay. Now, then after that, we are going to have another process where the sensitivity parameters that are current state as well as coin. Okay. So these are the two different sensitivity parameters. So depending on the changes in these two, there will be a program will get executed. Okay. So this process. So here we are going to consider a case statement where we are going to consider the variable that is a current state. Okay. And then if it is in a current state is a idle. Okay. Then coffee out will be equal to zero and coin out that will be equal to zero. And after that, next state that will be put money. Okay. So that means whenever we are starting our vending machine, so that time it will be in an idle state, and then at that time we are not going to give any coffee or coin out, that will not be there. But after that, the next state that will be put money. Okay. So after put money, when it is in a put money state, if coin in is equal to 0, 0, then coffee out will be equal to 0 and coin out that will be equal to 0, and next state that will be again equal to put money. Okay. So that means it will remain in the same state if there is no any coin. Okay. Now if coin in is equal to 0, 1, then coffee out will be equal to 0, coin out will be equal to 0, and next state will be equal to wrong money. So that means it will go in the state that is a wrong money. Okay. So that state I have not considered actually, but it while drawing a this FSM, but it will go in a wrong money state. That means now after this state, we are going to issue a money or refund money to the customer. Okay. Now if suppose coin in is equal to 1, 0, then again in that state, we are going to not going to give a coffee out, coffee or coin, but the next state that will be equal to in 5. Okay. After that, if suppose coin in is equal to 1, 1, then again coffee out will not be, or coffee out will be equal to 0, coin out that will be equal to 0, and next state that will be equal to in 10. Okay. So now if suppose, so end of this if statement, so we have considered all the four conditions for this coin in condition. So the, after that, if suppose the current state is equal to wrong money. Okay. So that means if coin in is equal to 0, 1, so it is going to be in a this state that is a wrong money. So in the after that, what we are going to do, coffee out that will be equal to 0, coin out equal to 1, that means we are going to return a coin, and then next state that will be equal to idle state, that means it will once again go into the first state. Okay. Now if the current state is equal to in 5, that means we have inserted 5 rupees coin. So coffee out that will be equal to 1, coin out will be equal to 0, and next state that will be idle. So that means it will go to the first condition, that is a reset. We can say it as a reset condition or the first condition. Now if the current state is equal to in 10, then coffee out is equal to 1, coin out is equal to 1, and next state is a idle. Okay. So in that way we have the program for this coffee vending machine. So end of this case statement, then end of the process, and end of the behavioral. Okay. So this all are the states for the this coffee vending machine, and depending on that we have written a VHDL code here. Okay, so now let us see its test bench. Okay, so I'll go for the test bench code. Okay, so as you know that whenever we are writing a test bench for any particular VHDL code, so we are associating that code with this test bench, and because of that we are going to get a skeleton for this test bench which will instantiate that component. Okay, so we have instantiated here a cafe vending machine component, so all the ports of that will be mapped to the ports of this unit under test. Okay, so whatever unit that we are going to test, for that all the ports that will be mapped. Okay, so initially we are having all these values that is equal to 0, so that initial value that will be equal to 0. Then these are the port mapping. We have the clock of 10 nanosecond, and we are going to keep a on time as well as off time for this clock as a 5 nanosecond. That means we are keeping actually 50% duty cycle, so it will be there. Okay, then after that we are having a actually stimulus for this input. Okay, so we are just going to give we are making a reset equal to 1. That means now it will check for the whatever different states are there. If reset is equal to 0, then it is going to remain in the idle state only. But if reset is equal to 1, so it will check for whatever is the input, and then depending on that it will go into the next states, and then we can get coffee or coin. Okay, so initially suppose that we have kept RST that is equal to 1, and then suppose coin in is equal to 0 0, then we are going to wait for 25 nanosecond. Okay, so that means if we have coin in is equal to 0 0, no any coin, so it coffee out will be equal to 0 as well as coin out that will be equal to 0, and then it will go into the next state, that or same state, it will remain in the state that is for put money. Okay, then if it is a 0 1, so that means wrong money that is inserted, so we can have coin out that is equal to 0, sorry, coin out equal to 1, and coin coffee out that is equal to 0. So that output we will get in this state, that is a coin in is equal to 1 0, we will get coffee out equal to 1 and coin out that is equal to 0, and then in if it is a 1 1, then we will get both coffee out as well as coin out. Okay, and then after that again I have kept this coin in that is equal to 0 0, that means it will remain in the put money state. Okay, so this is the test bench code for this. Okay, but before that let me show you RTL schematic for this. So this is the RTL schematic. So if you double click on this, you will get the internal diagram. So this will be the internal diagram and actual schematic. Okay, so overview of the IC, how IC will look like, that is we have seen earlier, and once after that we have seen whatever is the internal diagram. Okay, so now let us go to the test bench simulation. So I'll go to the simulation. And then check, first of all I'll check behavioral check syntax, and then I will just simulate this. So here you can see that whenever earlier coin in is equal to 0 0, okay, so this is the reset condition where reset is equal to 0, so it is going to remain in the idle state where coffee out and coin out both are 0 0. Okay, now in this state we have made reset equal to 1, but still coin in is equal to 0, 0. So coffee out and coin out, that will be equal to 0, 0. Okay. Now here we made coin out. We have coin in is equal to 0, 1. That means wrong coin is inserted, and therefore you will get here coffee out is equal to 0, but coin out, that will be equal to 1. Okay. Now here you can see coin in is equal to 1, 0. So coffee out is equal to 1, coin out is equal to 0. And here you can see that both, actually here it is in the earlier cycle, you can see here both coffee out and coin in is equal to 1, 1. So in that cycle actually there is no any output. Okay, in earlier cases also you can see that जरी इथं वन जातोय तरी पण त्या सायकल मध्ये आपला आउटपुट हाय नाही गेलं, तर ते नेक्स्ट सायकल मध्ये क्लॉक सायकल मध्ये हाय गेलं, कारण आपण या स्टेट मध्ये आपण देत नाही आहोत. आपण इथे काय करतोय, कॉफी आउट अँड कॉइन आउट झिरो करतो. व्हेनेव्हर इट इज गोइंग इन द नेक्स्ट सायकल, दॅट टाइम वी आर मेकिंग इट हाय. ओके, सो हियर 1, 1, दो इट इज अ 1, 1, सो हियर इट विल गो अ कॉफी आउट एज वेल एज कॉइन आउट, दॅट इज इक्वल टू 1, 1. ओके, सो हियर यू विल रिसीव coffee as well as coin also, return money will be there. Okay, so this is about the VHDL code for this coffee vending machine. Okay, anybody has doubt about this? Yes, anybody has doubt?
No ma'am.
Okay, so is it possible for you to write a simple VHDL code for सिंपल कॉफी वेंडिंग मशीन, जिथे तुम्हाला काय करायचंय की कॉइन इन्सर्ट करायचंय आणि कॉफी मिळायची, म्हणजे त्याच्यामध्ये आपण कुठलं कॉइन आहे काय आहे हे बघणारच नाही, आपण फक्त कॉइन आलं ना की आपण कॉफी देणार आहे, त्याच्यासाठी तो कोड लिहिता येईल. ओके, सो दिस इज फॉर युअर होमवर्क, यू हॅव टू राईट अ VHDL कोड फॉर अ व्हेरी सिंपल कॉफी वेंडिंग मशीन वेअर इफ यू आर इन्सर्टिंग मनी यू विल गेट अ कॉफी. Okay, there is no any return money option. Okay, and we are considering that coin is of a 5 rupees or 10 rupees, whatever is the cost of that coffee. Okay, that means you must have seen a earlier coin box phone. Okay, ज्याच्यामध्ये 1 रुपये टाकला की कॉल होत होता, 60 सेकंडसाठी कॉल. मला माहित नाही किती जणांनी पाहिलंय तशा टाईपचे फोन, पण त्याच्यामध्ये काय होतं की 1 रुपया टाकला की कॉल तुमचा कनेक्ट व्हायचा, 1 रुपया म्हणजे 60 सेकंडसाठी कॉल तुमचा जॉईन व्हायचा, आणि ते 60 सेकंड संपले की कॉल परत तुम्हाला कॉइन इन्सर्ट करावं लागेल. ओके, सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ एक्झाम्पल दॅट वी आर कन्सिडरिंग, यू आर इन्सर्टिंग अ कॉइन अँड देन यू विल गेट अ कॉफी. ओके, म्हणजे तुमचं आउटपुट एकच असेल, कॉफी आउट हे आउटपुट असेल, आणि तुम्ही इनपुट काय करताय, कॉफी म्हणजे कॉइन इन करताय, इनपुट कॉइन जर असेल तर तुम्हाला आउटपुट मिळेल. ओके, सो दिस इज युअर homework that you have to write a simple VHDL code for this statement. Okay, so for today we will stop here, we will have another example in the next session. Okay, so till then bye, you can leave this meeting.